Good morning, Vietnam. Made me think of Robin Williams. May he rest in. Well, I can't say rest in peace because he killed himself. Okay, that went a different way. But anyway, happy Monday. Good morning. Me and Jared have had an amazing last 4 days. I mean, amazing. I know it's only four, but that's huge for us, you know, because there's always something going on with him, with me, us together. There's always something crazy going on. So we've been celebrating. Seriously, even Jared, the last 2 days, Mom, oh my gosh, I feel so good. And things is just great. It really, really is. I feel clean spiritually. Like, I just feel, like I was just washed. Literally. You know, like we sing a lot of church songs. He washed me. I was sinking deep in sin. And, but the last few days, and nothing like major has happened. It's just, I've just changed my heart and my mindset in regards to a few things. And it's funny because you would think the changes God has me going through, it's kind of like not so much a super duper positive, but it is. Because sometimes it carries more weight on a positive side, spiritually, than naturally. And spiritually is the most important, so. But I do. I just feel so much lighter. Like, I feel like I've been, like, almost literally, like I've lost, like, 50 pounds. That's how light I feel. Maybe not 50, maybe 35 or 40. But I feel good. I really do. God is just good. He is. Bless Jesus. Yesterday, oh my gosh, after church, I almost had a little panic episode. I have my mom on this. This lifeline, like if you press it, then you know, they'll call her. If she don't answer, they'll call 911 and the people on her emergency contact list. And I have myself, Jared, because we're always together, myself, Jared, my sister, and my two nephews. Honey, when we were driving, I was taking Jared to the movies after church yesterday. When Jared answered his cell phone, when he looked, he was like, Mom, I don't know what number this is. And plus, it's a new number. So I said, just answer it anyway, you know. And they said it was Lifeline. Honey, he just handed me the phone. He was so scared. And the scary, sad, but good part is that even if something did happen yesterday, how my spirit was, it was like I was okay. Like, if God chose to take my mom yesterday, if her heart, you know, her pacemaker went out or she tripped and fell, God, I mean, I'm so thankful that he didn't. But yesterday was the first time in my entire life that I wasn't like, oh my gosh, because that's usually how I am. Lord, I'm sorry. That's the second time like I just kind of cruised through a red light. Well, half my car was kind of like technically already through it, if that counts. God's like, no, so shut up. Okay, I'll repent 10 times. But I was okay, you know, which was like relatively weird. Usually I am always in panic mode. Do you hear me? I mean, always, like, my mom, oh my gosh, like, Lord, please don't take my mom. Like, I go through this whole, like, and I don't want to have panic attacks, but, like, my mom, honey, sheesh. Jesus. My mom and my dad. I will hurt something. Yes. I've calmed down a lot. But was okay. And I was sharing that with Jared, and even he was saying, he was like, Mom, you were calm. I said, honey, it takes Jesus to fix it all. And I said, Lord, I hope you're not preparing me. Even if you are preparing me, prepare me for what may come 10 years from now. No less than five for Greece in your numerology, Jesus. But whatever his will is, of course. But just always praying and hoping and desiring for growth and change and maturity and higher heights and deeper depths in him, for him. Just have to be ready, keep your mind right, keep your hands clean, have a yes already available at the tip of your lips, have an obedient spirit, have a clean and weightless heart. Sheesh. But you know what? Some of the things I've gone through, you know, I used to be the queen of principle, the queen of justification. And you know what? The pain that I experience in these life moments is not greater than my assignment. Oh, that'll preach, yes. Wow. But that's true, though. The pain that I go through, it does not compare to the assignment that he has me on and called me to do. Because the pain that I go through, he's like, pain? How can you even say pain compared to what he's even been through, you know? So, give God the glory, the honor. And I know I fail him, not even sometimes, a lot of times. It may not be nothing huge like other people may think, but it's the little foxes, honey. The little foxes. It's the just take one apple to destroy the whole tree, you know. It can just take some bad soil to be in the foundation, and the tree will never even grow. And it can look pretty, they can lay the manure down, but it's like, why won't nothing grow? Because the foundation, the soil, which you're using to make it grow, has been tainted. So, every day it's a repenting mode. You know, sometimes my thoughts are, you know, I get upset or angry at something or somebody, you know. That's how the enemy tries to get a sidetrack, people, places, and things. So, I have to keep my spirit filled. Just like I make sure I put something in my stomach to eat or a snack or dinner, I have to do that spiritually as well. Alrighty, yens. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Okay, bye-bye.